fact that it is not a cumbersome technology to onboard, and is very easy to integrate into different business processes. If you think about a lot of data source operators who are out there, not all of them are going to be crypto capable or crypto savvy, right? They may have accounting rules that prevent them from touching crypto on their balance sheet, or they just may not be set up for the infrastructure to manage those sorts of payment receipts and that type of infrastructure. So that flexibility to start still blending those two points of, let's say, real world from the old space to this universe is important and is probably going to enable a lot more adaptation and adoption by those who are dipping their feet for the first time, rather than those who are already crypto native or crypto savvy, if you will. Mm. That was, in my opinion, at least personally, a great advantage to API 3. And I think the fact that we're not dealing with some of these curated Oracle services where there is a list of instruments and a relatively more limited set of products that can actually be connected to as far as a collection of tickers, because of the lack of the need to have multi-party consensus to publish a data point, actually massively increases the utility of something like this.